That's Alex Krupp of the Parkettes team, the host club here in Allentown, Pennsylvania. Their gig, the 30th annual Parkettes Invitational. Legendary here in the Pennsylvania region. We're about 30 miles north of Philadelphia and just a little bit south of the Pocono Mountains. You're Easton, Pennsylvania.
Alex is 16. She was born here in Allentown. And I made a mistake a minute ago. I said that Paige Cipollone was 13. She had a birthday just the other day. She's 14.
Wow.
I want to make sure I get that right.
Darn right.
This is Alex's favorite event for exercise.
Whoa.
Oh, and she's powerful, too. Right out of bounds.
Now she stepped over the white line. That's a deduction.
She was second in this event at 2003 level 10 state.
So one of her favorite things to do is ride roller coasters. Well,
I'm right down for that. Dorney Park, one of the great roller coasters in all of America here in Allentown.
Not to mention the entire sport of gymnastics is like riding a roller coaster.
Yeah, what a shock that is. Oh!
Every time you go out of bounds, you lose a tenth of a point for going out of the area.
Current point.
Usually there's another deduction for the stumble on the landing as well.
Point leader in this event is Corey Hartung, 9.65. With Lindsay Vandenick hold next at 9.0. Oh, they're tied at 9.65 each.
Two and a half at the end of a Floratine to dismount.
Yeah, the full range of emotion in that performance. Alex Krupp for the Parkettes. A moment ago on the runway for the vault is little Monica Soji with a big run.
And that's incredible. It's incredible how much height she can get being so short. She's just got to get up on that table, much less get over it.
She's literally shorter than the vaulting table itself. Monica Soji in the vault, scored a 9.375. Where Alicia Sacramone is the leader at 9.625. Alyssa Brown has scored 9.5 on the vault, 9.35 on the bars, and now prepares to mount the balance beam. Alyssa Brown. The leader is Nicole Harris in this exercise at 9.8.
That's tough. She just went right off the beam on a side summy. And doing the side summy, it's a side flip. And, of course, you have to land facing outwards, almost staring at the judges. And it can be a little unnerving. It's one of the more difficult skills to land.
Next on board is the Parkette, Amber Kane.
Oh.
And that was a nice series. One arm by canceling to let out step out.
Next on ball for Hill.
You come off the bar. Is there an automatic point deduction?
Or
is
it?
Yeah.
A fall is half a tenth on every event.
This team out of Canada, as we mentioned earlier, really grooming these young ladies for the next go-around, not necessarily for the 2004 Olympics, but for a shot at the 2008 Olympics. They're junior gymnasts.
And a very nice finish for Alyssa Brown. We'll take a look at it again, and when we come back, it'll be the final round of exercise for these young gymnasts from the 2004 Parkette Invitational on CN8. CN8's coverage of the 2004 Parkette Invitational. The Parkette Training Center is known throughout the United States for producing world-class gymnasts, but there's more to Parkettes than developing the next Olympian. Let's take a look. The Lehigh Valley in Allentown, PA, where the Parquette's National Gymnastics Training Center has been teaching for 35 years. Its beginnings were local in the 60s, but they've grown into a nationally acclaimed training center.
We've been here 35 years now, and we've had several Olympians, Pan American Games team members, and we're at about 112 national team members, which is a record of any club in this country.
Parquette members have won their share of national and international championships, and a few to the Olympics. This year, Nicole Harris is one of the Parquette's Olympic hopefuls who believe in the teaching philosophies at Parquette.
There's no other gym I would trust more than Parquette's. Their coaching, I trust so much, and now that I've been here 3 years, I can see how much they care for me and know what's best for me.
Committed to the Allentown community, Parquette offers programs for Special Olympians as well. One of their elite athletes in this division is Michael Gall.
Michael loves to perform. He's a real natural. He just loves to perform, and he's really good at gymnastics. He's 33 years old, mind you, it's amazing that he can still do what he was showing us today. It's a big commitment. It's a lot of fun. It's a social thing for the athletes and the parents. They see themselves, they watch the girls and the boys train here that do the regular gymnastics, and they see themselves as equals, which I think is great.
Whether it's working with Special Olympians or giving young people the right positive encouragement,
all right,
well done,
or developing Olympic hopefuls, the Parquette Training Center has become one of the top spots in the United States to shape and mold the gymnasts of the future. From Allentown, Pennsylvania, in the Lehigh Valley, just north of Philadelphia, Lou Tilley, Bart Connor, Shannon Miller. And Shannon, this young lady who slipped a bit on the beam, no pun intended, Morgan Evans, needs to have a strong performance here in the overall on the floor exercise.
Absolutely, but if you look at her vault score, 9.5, that tells me she's powerful, so I'm hoping this is going to be an excellent floor routine.
She fell to seventh place after scoring just 9.0 on the balance beam. Nicole Harris, the overall leader, as we begin the final round of exercise.
Nice triple fold open.
Changes of pace in the music, and you can see it reflected in her routine at each juncture.
It's nice. It kind of keeps the judges a little bit more awake when you have a little bit of a change in the music.
There's another.
One of the things I always try to do was have some slow music light right before my last time I pass so I could press. Twist.
Morgan Evans,
Morgan
Excalibur.
Evans from the Excalibur team.